energy stored in a capacitor, energy stored in a capacitor is equal to work done in charging the capacitor. Initially, we assume that two plates 1 and 2 of a capacitor are uncharged, means there is no charge on plate 1 and 2. Now, we start the process of charging. We transfer positive charge from plate 2 to 1. In this condition, what happens when we transfer the charge from 2 to 1 bit by bit? At any intermediate position, when charge Q dash is present on plate 1 and minus Q dash is present on plate 2, that time we transfer positive charge delta Q dash from plate 2 to 1. In this condition, what happens? Potential difference between the two plates 1 and 2 is V dash equal to Q dash upon C. Now a small charge delta Q dash transferred from plate 2 to 1. The work done is what? Delta W equal to V dash delta Q. V dash is what? Q dash upon C. Delta W equal to Q dash upon C delta Q dash. The total work done in transferring a charge Q from plate 2 to 1 will be calculated by W equal to integration of delta W from 0 to Q, Q dash upon C dQ dash. 1 upon C as a common, 0 to Q, Q dash dQ dash. We know that the formula xn dx equal to xn plus 1 upon n plus 1. So W equal to 1 upon C, Q dash 1 plus 1 upon 1 plus 1, 0 to Q, 1 upon C equal to Q dash square upon 2, 0 to Q. So W equal to 1 upon 2 as a common, 2C equal to Q square minus 0 square. Q is upper limit, 0 is lower limit. W equal to 1 by 2 Q square upon C. This work done is stored as electrical potential energy U of the capacitor. U equal to 1 by 2 Q square upon C. On substituting the value of Q equal to what? CV. So U equal to 1 by 2 C square V square upon C. 1 C cancel. What we get? U equal to 1 by 2 CV square. On substituting value C equal to Q upon V in this relation, what we get? U equal to 1 by 2 Q square upon Q upon V. Q Q cancel. U equal to 1 by 2 QV. Hence, we have an expression U equal to 1 by 2 Q square upon C equal to 1 by 2 CV square equal to 1 by 2 QV. Energy density of an electric field between two plates of a parallel plate capacitor. For a parallel plate capacitor, capacitance C equal to epsilon naught A upon D. Electric field between two plates E equal to sigma upon epsilon naught, or sigma equal to epsilon naught E. And surface charge density sigma equal to what? Q upon A. So Q equal to what? Sigma A. Hence Q equal to what? Sigma A. Sigma is what? Epsilon naught E. So Q equal to epsilon naught E A. Energy stored in the capacitor is what? U equal to 1 by 2 Q square upon C. We substitute the value Q equal to what? Epsilon naught E A upon C equal to what? Epsilon naught A upon D. So U equal to 1 by 2 epsilon naught square E square A square upon value of C is what? Epsilon naught A upon D. So U equal to 1 by 2 epsilon naught square E square A square upon epsilon naught A D go up. So cancel epsilon naught A and A. So what we get? U equal to 1 by 2 epsilon naught E square A into D. A into D is what? Volume of the capacitor between its two plates. The energy stored per unit volume, or the energy density of the electric field, is given by U equal to capital U upon A into D. A into D is what? Volume. 1 by 2 epsilon naught E into D E square upon A into D. So a cancel, d d cancel, what we get? U equal to 1 by 2 epsilon naught e square. Energy distribution in series combination of capacitor. For a series combination, q is what? Constant. And equivalent capacitance 1 upon c equal to 1 upon c1 plus 1 upon c2 plus 1 upon c3. Total energy equal to q square upon 2c. So into 1 upon c. So q square upon 2 into 1 upon c. We just substitute 1 upon c1 plus 1 upon c2 plus 1 upon c3. So u equal to 1 by 2 q square upon c1 plus 1 by 2 q square upon c2 plus 1 by 2 q square upon c3. This one is what? Electrical potential energy of capacitor 1, electrical potential energy of capacitor 2, electrical potential energy of capacitor 3. So U equal to U1 plus U2 plus U3. Next, energy distribution in parallel combination of capacitors. For a parallel combination, C equal to V equal to constant, not C. V equal to constant and equivalent capacitance C equal to C1 plus C2 plus C3. So total energy U equal to what? 1 by 2 C V square. We substitute the value of C equal to what? C1 plus C2 plus C3 here. So what we get? U equal to 1 by 2 C1 V square plus 1 by 2 C2 V square plus 1 by 2 C3 V square. This one is what? Energy of capacitor 1, this is energy of capacitor 2, this is energy of capacitor 3. So U equal to U1 plus U2 plus U3. Hence total energy is a additive in series and parallel combination of capacitor. Redistribution of charges. First we assume that two conductor A and B are separated and they have no connection. We consider two insulated conductor A and B of capacitance C1 and C2 and carrying charges Q1 and Q2 respectively. Let V1 and V2 be their respective potential, then Q1 equal to C1V and Q equal to Q2 equal to C2V. Total charge Q equal to Q1 plus Q2 or Q equal to C1 V1 plus C2V2. This one is our equation number 1. Now what we do, if two conductors are joined by a thin conducting wire, the positive charge flow from high potential to low potential until their potential become equal and equal to what value? V. After redistribution, charge on conductor A is what? Q1 dash equal to C1 V. V is what? Common potential. And charge on conductor 2 B, conductor B is Q2 dash equal to C2 V. So total charge Q equal to Q1 dash plus Q2 dash because charge all remain conserved. So C1 V plus C2 V, Q equal to C1 plus C2 V. From 1 and 2, Q is same. So right hand side of both the equation equal. So C1 plus C2 V equal to C1 V1 plus C2 V2 or V equal to C1 V1 plus C2 V2 upon C1 plus C2. This can also written as, this one is what? Total charge. This one is what? Total charge. And this is what? Total capacitance. Total capacitance. So in this condition we can write total charge upon total capacitance. After redistribution, Q1 dash upon Q2 dash equal to C1V upon C2V. VV cancel. Q1 dash upon Q2 dash equal to C1 upon C2. Thus, after redistribution, the charges on two conductor are in the ratio of their capacitance. Thank you.